Hi everyone, I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. Here we have the seismic signature as it comes in there at Earthquake Canada. One signature just went across. We got another one here at 1505. This is for every 10 minutes of data. This one is every hour. Yeah, Alberta, Canada is rocking and rolling, and I'm not surprised. Let me show you. You recognize this? This is a 4.8. This was probably the 4 shock. These are all oil platforms. All right, let me bring it out. There's the 5.0. They also have on EMSE a 3.8. It's actually caused by the disposal of the wastewater or pumping in the water into the ground to crack the ground and to force the gas and the oil to come up. So it shook up the Yellowstone caldera. Here is the first one. It came in there at Yellowstone at 4:49. This was the magnitude 4.8. That probably would be classified as a 4 shock. Some of the reports on EMSE says it sounded and felt like a bulldozer was walking up our driveway. House was cracking and floor was vibrating. Could hear a roar. Lasted around 10 seconds. USGS gave it an intensity level of 4. 18 people said they felt that, reported it to USGS. So that came in, I believe, at 8:46 a.m. local time. Felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. At night, they would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, and doors would have been rattling. Automobiles rocked noticeably. Here's the location of the felt reports. Let's see, High Prairie, intensity level 4. Grimshaw, intensity level 3. Intensity level 2, I'm not going to try and pronounce that. I just end up murdering the name. Edmonton, intensity level 2. Did I do that one? Yeah, I did. Okay. And I did that one. Did I do that one? Grand Prairie. Okay, I did High Prairie, and that's Grand Prairie. Let's zoom in a little bit. Slave Lake, intensity level 3. There's other earthquakes on here, but I'm gonna stick with this right now. And yeah, look at that. Made the caldera slosh around. And then let's go down here because this probably is the 5.0. That's universal time. 8:59 a.m. 43 people said they felt that earthquake. Intensity level 5. Yeah, here you can see we got spreading going on. Here's some of the felt reports from EMSE. House shook strongly. Lots of cracking. Drum in top load washer machine was shaking. Wow. I woke in the second floor of a school and noticed my office shaking and my computer shook. Others in my school felt it too. Sitting on my couch watching TV and the couch started vibrating. Sex Smith, Canada, which is about 98 miles, I believe, southwest. I just noticed a very brief moment of wondering what I was feeling and then noticed my computer was shaking slightly. Only lasted a few seconds and was very subtle. I live in Teepee Creek, Alberta, about 30 minutes northeast of Grand Prairie. More recently, they had a magnitude 3.8. This report comes from Greenview, number 16, Canada. That's 116 kilometers southwest. So that would be about 72 miles, again, southwest. Felt my house shift for a second and thought, I had imagined it, but the water was moving in my water cooler for a few seconds afterwards. 137 miles south, or 220 kilometers, Fox Creek, Canada. Felt plant stand shook. A dull thump. 216 miles southeast, or 349 kilometers, Edmonton, Canada. Office chair and desk moving. Some dishes rattling in the kitchen. So going to the monitor for Yellowstone, there's the seismic signature for the 5.0. Let's look at the spectrogram. Yeah, it really shook up. Lasted quite a while. I'll bring it over. Yeah, you can see the heat that came up. Hot water, hot gases. Yeah, see that? How it came up? Those lines are hot water and gases. All right, let's bring this over. All right, and let me pull this up so you can see all four monitors. We'll go to the borehole 207. Yeah, we got other earthquakes on here. This here is the Madison River borehole. This borehole is 661 feet to the seismometers and to the strain meter, 687 feet. Let me bring this up so you can see we got metal casing, and at the very top is a cap of cement. All right, there's the first earthquake. We'll go to the spectrogram. Not too bad. Let's bring it over a little bit. Oh, there you can see the heat and the heated water right there. Okay, I believe that's the foreshock 4.8. This here is the 5.0. And we'll go to the signature. Yeah, definitely made it all go sloshing around, and it actually created where we had some popping of the ground. Yeah, and like I said, there's some other earthquakes on here. Let me bring it up. Haven't had a chance to see if USGS has reported any of them. We have two, a 0.6, yeah, right, at 2:46, and a 1.3, that would have been yesterday, at 15:20. So we got this at 109, and I come up with a magnitude 4.07. I'm not sure where it happened at. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, if it was there, I doubt if it was there at Yellowstone, big time. Now New Zealand had an earthquake of a 4.2. Yeah, at 101. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. 1:36 universal time. All right, that one was at Yellowstone. A magnitude 1.3, they said. 4.4 kilometers in depth, or 2.7 miles. I come up with a magnitude 1.95. And then there was several others. Let me go to the seismic signature. All right, let me bring this up. And we'll pull it over a little bit. We got another one red right there. I wonder if I can make it bigger for you. Okay. Right there. See, there was several earthquakes. We got a small one here. Let's take this one right here. Well, I probably should, because it just grew in size, I probably should do the whole thing. All right, so we'll go there, which comes in as a magnitude 2.11. That one they are not reporting. And let me go back to the seismic signature. Well, actually, it was probably even bigger because you can see how it popped. It popped again, and it grew in size, and then we had a smaller one afterwards. Yeah. All right, let's go. That's fault movement. Let me go to this one here. Yeah, again, fault movement or tectonic plate movement. You know, they do have that fault, the Teton fault that runs through here. We got another one right there that's not being reported. That is not in red. None of the monitors that I downloaded have it in red. Over here, we got Mary Lake. This is the borehole for the Madison River. This is the borehole for Yellowstone Lake. And on the far right is western boundary. All right, so let's go to the borehole for the Madison River. They're not reporting it. That comes in as a magnitude. Oops, let me bring it down. As a magnitude 1.72. I got the same for Mary Lake. Let me go over here and I'll show you. Okay, right there. And I'll pull it down. All right, one point, not far enough. There you go, 1.72. And then there's another little one right there. Just a little thing. Let's look at the seismic signature. Yeah, just a little one. And again, this, sorry about that. Let's bring this up. I wanted to take a peek what Yellowstone was showing. Yeah, a little dirty, the steam coming up here. Now, earlier, yesterday, we got a lot of magma that was coming into the system. We got one marked in, well, actually, there's several marked in red here. 1540. Let me see if I can find it. Doesn't show, well, right there. Okay. And, okay, 1540. Let's see if I can find it for this one. Right there. Okay, and we got four monitors that it shows up on. They're not reporting it. Okay. Let's look at the spectrogram. Okay, western boundary. Yeah, that's a while. All right, let's make that one bigger. Yep, there's another one marked in red too, but let's do this one first. That one comes in, let me bring it down, as a magnitude 1.80, but it sure brought up a lot of magma. Look how hot that was. And look at the hot gases not being reported. Okay, and then there's another one not being reported right there. 1601. That comes in as a magnitude 1.70. Again, this is the western boundary. I did not download Denny Creek, and I've talked about this area. I believe there is a crack in the ground where the magma is trying to come up. And yeah, you can see the thickening of the lines. Let me close this. Yeah, how it was really. Yeah, look at that. Let me come down over here. We'll come down a little bit farther. It went on for several hours. And then we had that earthquake. Then we had the other earthquake. And, oh, let me go up a little bit. Where did it settle down? About there, maybe. Yeah, very concerning. And then we got some little ones here, too. Those are shallow. I'm looking to see if we got screaming going on. I don't see any screaming. This is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Yeah, we got one, two, three, four lines of melt. Yeah, more blobs of magma coming in over here. See, this is the borehole for the Madison River area. And again, these are the more recent ones that they're not reporting. And then we got another one marked in red there. I don't know if I reported it or not. 1600. We got another one there. Another one there. 1540. Yeah, I think I did. Yeah, I think I did. But anyways, yeah, look at this here. Let me go to the seismic signature. Can I make that bigger? Yeah. Oh, it's up and down and wavy and... Yeah, it was really shaking there. Can you see that down there on that line? Normally, you get that when there's a large earthquake someplace around the world. Yeah, see this 109? I don't see anything other than possibly New Zealand. That probably is New Zealand. Yeah, it made the earth ring like a bell. That's what that one is. Okay. Yep, even affected Yellowstone. So we got, Panama, Cuba, Dominican Republic, Jamaica, China. More from China. Another one from China. Alaska. Yeah, let me click on that so you can see it maybe better. And I'll pull it over to the time. So, yeah, that's what happened. Yep. Yeah, I did that report earlier today about that earthquake, and yeah, look at that. This is the Aleutian Islands. So the sloshing around there, that earthquake in New Zealand, or by New Zealand, I think it was, what, a 6.0? Yeah, created some earthquakes here at Yellowstone afterwards. See that? Let me make that bigger. This is Mary Lake. But they're not reporting these. Yeah. Well, just like Michael Poland said, there could be a large earthquake somewhere else in the world. And if Yellowstone was ready to, you know, go off. So it just created some earthquakes here is what it did. Yeah, later. Yeah, let's go to the signature. See them all? More telling when you're looking at the spectrogram. Yeah. Interesting. Anyways, that's all I have for you right now. Large fracking earthquake. Yeah. Things they do to our planet, huh? Anyways, be prepared for a disaster. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Yeah, when I came home, I went shopping and had a restock on some mayonnaise, making sure everything is rotated in stock. And I came home, I seen this. Everyone should be preparing for any type of disaster. You just don't know. It beats inflation if you do it now. So what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please make sure you're still subscribed. The AI here on YouTube unsubscribes people for some reason. I don't know. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.